Come before him in joyful singing. Know that the Lord himself is God. It is he who has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, bless his name, for the Lord is good. His loving kindness is everlasting, and his faithfulness to all generations.
Thank you. CCF member, Brother Paul is from Vancouver. I think you drive from Vancouver coming here. Yeah?
I'm just passing by.
Oh, yeah. Thank you for passing us here. And Sister Norma is from, thank you, Brother Paul. And Sister Norma is a visiting from CCF Alabama.
Thank you so much, Pastor Neil, for that wonderful introduction. Let's read it all together. Ready? Go. Do everything without complaining or arguing, so that you may become blameless and pure, children of God, without fault in a crooked and depraved generation, in which you shine like stars in the universe as you hold out the word of life, in order that I may boast on the day of Christ that I do not run or labor for nothing. It says there, do everything without complaining or arguing. Now, I told you a while ago that complaining is so common in our lives. The question is it wrong? Is it wrong to complain? Who says it's wrong? Raise your hand. Okay, the process is do nothing or do everything without complaining or arguing, right?
In other words, brothers and sisters, the person says do nothing or do everything without grumbling or arguing is connected to Philippians chapter 2, the book chapter, the context of chapter 2, which is having the attitude of Jesus Christ in our hearts, in our minds, in our lives, who, although he was God, did not consider it equality with God as something to hold on to, but rather he humbled himself and became a servant like humans. He became obedient to the Father, even dying on the cross for us. That kind of attitude. Philippians chapter 2 is saying that kind of attitude of humility and servanthood should be in us. Considering others better than ourselves. Looking for the interests of one another. That's the whole chapter of Philippians chapter 2. That's why when we have responsibilities as a church, we do not complain. We do not say, oh, why is brother or sister not given that much attention? Or why is this brother or sister having this responsibility and not come? I'm better than him. I can do more than him. And instead of looking for the benefit or for the good of one another, we look at our own interests, our own me first. That's what the verse is talking about. Do not argue, do not complain. Instead, you should do everything without complaining or arguing, so that you may become blameless and pure. Children of God go fall in a warm and crooked generation. Didn't God, Jesus Christ said, by this all men shall know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Same thing that he's talking about here. If you love your brother or your sister so much that you're willing to step down and be humble and serve instead of being lifted up and being acknowledged, then the people that are visiting us and looking at us, they will say, oh wow, this guy is really big business. Christianity is so evident in them. They don't have to preach long sermons. They don't have to say that all you need to be baptized, you need to repent and be saved, because I can see it in their lives. Jesus did it for us. Jesus died on the cross and rose again to give us an example that even if you go through difficulties in life, still we will overcome. Still we will be victorious. And still we will one day praise and thank Him. Lord, thank you because you allowed me to go through those difficult times in my life. Thank you because without those times, Lord God, I wouldn't be where I am. I wouldn't be like you. Brothers and sisters, this morning, God is saying, trust me. For He loves you so much. He loves each one of us so much. We need to be humble and receive His blessings. Shall we pray? Lord, this morning, I thank you because you laid before us, Lord God, the truth about our attitudes and minds when we complain and we, Lord, murmur, and we say to you that, Lord, I don't know what's going on. But this morning you're telling us, Lord God, that we should be having the attitude that Jesus Christ, your Son, had. He displayed humility, obedience, servanthood, sacrifice, in order to show to us an example of that, of what our behaviors, what our attitudes should be. Lord, for letting us know that you love us, you care for us. Nothing is going on in our lives that you don't know. But you desire us to grow. You desire us, Lord God, to be conformed to your Son, Jesus Christ. And you allow these things, Lord, to go to happen, Lord God, in our days, so that we would learn to trust you in the need. Father, this morning I pray for my brothers and sisters that are going through difficulties in life, that are experiencing hardships, Lord God, they're questioning the faith. I pray that you would touch them this morning, Lord God. Comfort them. I pray for us, Lord God, who desire to be used by you mightily. That Father God, we just allow your Holy Spirit to work in us, to mold us to become the person that you want us to be. In order for us to be used for you, Lord. I pray, Holy Spirit, that this morning you will cause our hearts to be quickened, Lord God. For our ears to listen, for our eyes to be open to the truth of your word. Thank you for your presence, Holy Spirit. We praise you, we thank you, and we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Lord, for the message that we learned today from our brother Jeff, that we shared with our brother Jeff.